you mean. Breaking through glass cages inside of me. Surfing and swimming in a never-ending sea. Finding missing puzzles to keep. Crack the cracking for everyone to sleep. Illusions walking and living like zombies. Allowing people to play with my mind like chess piece. Stole the key to my psyche. Hello, Taurus. Welcome to Leo season. It's your girl and me here with another reading for the current season. This is a general reading, so this may or may not resonate for you. Astrology is being included for this general reading. However, we all have all 12 signs in our chart, so it can apply to you regardless of what your sun sign is. Thank you for your likes, shares, and subscriptions. I truly do appreciate it. Please share this video with anyone that you feel it may resonate for, regardless of sun sign. So, the message that I have for you is build a more stable foundation. Do not overindulge in pain or the past. This full moon opposition with Saturn, Jupiter, and Aquarius is to help you get out of the house. So I know Taurus loves their comfort and stability, but it's time for things to be shaken up. So let's get into this, shall we? Okay, so I'm using the Black Moon and clarifying with the Modern Witch, just so you know. All right, so the first card out, we have the 12th house, escape. Makes perfect sense. Second card we have is Chiron, healing. Okay. Third position we have Solar Eclipse, Revolution. Alrighty. So this could have been something that began during the Solar Eclipse and will close out the next Solar Eclipse. And lastly, you have your house, your ruling house, the second house, owning. Okay, so I definitely see this as you making a complete change and coming back to yourself. And at the bottom we have Aries, I am, which is 12th house to Taurus energy. So this definitely has a lot to do with your subconscious breaking through to let you know, hey, this is who you are, this is what you need to be doing, and you need to get on your shit. So this the opportunity for that comes during both full moon cycles. We just had one at 1 degree Aquarius, which is conjuncting the point where we had the big conjunction with Saturn and Jupiter, December 21st 2020. The second one will be August 22nd, where the full moon is going to conjunct Jupiter. So let's get into this. The first position is the underlying situation, which is the 12th house escape. And the 12th house does have to do with ways of escaping the physical reality, because the 12th house is Piscean energy. So it's all about the ethereal, the light and dark side of the situation. You may be trying to escape either the light or the dark side of a situation that you need to deal with concerning your home, your foundation, or your roots. And we need to address it head on so you can deal with it, because it has to do with who you are. Here we got Aquarius energy right here, letting you know that you need to be more logical than emotional, and face the situation head on. Even if it, because she's holding a sword, you may need to have a conversation with someone that you feel is trying to escape their reality or the situation at hand. And you're guaranteed a victory that you need to protect with the Seven of Wands at the bottom. So if you do need to have a conversation with someone about either how you're feeling and how you're doing, or how someone else is feeling and doing, and escapism or altering their reality may be involved, there is success in this situation. Especially if you are demonstrating compassion during the conversation rather than allowing your ego to get in the way, or someone else allowing their ego to get in the way. In the second position we have Chiron, healing, and this is what we want to pay attention to. Are we trying to heal the situation, or are we ignoring the ability to heal the situation and make it better for not only us but everyone involved? So, and it's a number 8, so it is karmic. So, yeah, this 5 of Swords here tells me that, there may be someone in the situation, whether it's you or the other person, who may be trying to avoid healing the situation in order to get out of the situation at hand. I could see this as you trying to have a conversation with someone, or someone trying to have a conversation with you to let you know that something needs to change in order to heal a situation or make it better, and make it your power rather than your weakness. And it's falling on deaf ears. It's falling on deaf ears. Yeah. So either you have to walk away from the situation like, you know, well, I tried, or someone else has to walk away from the situation like, well, I tried, you know, but they're not listening for real, because they don't want to learn the lessons, or they don't want to accept that there's a higher reason or a higher perspective that needs to be addressed at play. And this is your card, this is your energy. It's the number 5, that change needs to happen. Change has to happen. And how you deal with certain people or situations, either you or that person. But, you know, the opportunity is present for there to be some form of healing in the conversation. But being open-minded will definitely help you and whoever this conversation is pertinent to in your life. And it may be a challenge for you or that person to be open-minded in the conversation, but just know that it's coming from a higher source or a higher plane that has to take place. It has to take place. And then during this Leo season, it's an opportunity. So what we want to utilize is the solar eclipse revolution. So solar eclipses are about change, a new beginning. And we have the Knight of Pentacles. So the situation is being rebuilt in a new way. There's a new person or a new support system coming in. Could be new money as well, since it's a pentacle. But this is Virgo energy, which is a supportive trine with Taurus. So there could be a Virgo or someone with strong Virgo energies. Or this could also be like, you know, someone having a conversation with you about, you know, facing the realities of the situation. And it may be hard to accept, but it ends up allowing you to change your day-to-day circumstances to where you feel like you're in the beneficial part rather than you just being dumped with all of the dirty work that you have to do. You start to look at your responsibilities differently, which makes you feel like you can handle the situation and it's only up from here. And maybe that is the biggest shift or change that's actually needed in this in order for you to, you know, wake up. It's time for, if this is a card talking about having a wake-up call, making things right again. But it's a, like you have to reawaken something that's within you that hasn't been here for a while in order for you to get on a good foot and get moving. So the last card we have is the second house owning, which is the outcome. So what we're trying to, look at that, Ten of Cups. This is what you want. This is what you want to have. It requires you to face certain aspects of yourself and others that you do not want to hear, and that you know is the truth, but you may just try to escape it. But you can't escape it anymore. But once you allow yourself to change your perspective on what's healthy and unhealthy for you on a daily basis, your daily routine, you end up with this outcome of a dream come true, a wish fulfillment for you when it comes to your value and how you feel about things going up. And we got the Tower moment here. So I can definitely see this as like having like uncanny success with a new idea that was given to you on how you can do something differently. And again, the overall message at the bottom is I am. This is about you reawakening to the true essence of who you are. And it may mean that you need to face in opposition the opportunities for you to get outside of your body or get outside of the need to be comfortable all the time and do something that may seem a little left field but will actually be a benefit to you once you have recognized how it's beneficial to you. If you continue to look at every circumstance or situation that is new, that requires change being offered to you as something that isn't going to work out for you, you may end up missing out on the opportunity to heal a part of yourself that deserves your attention. And you're not going to be able to completely be yourself because you haven't given your chance to, you haven't given yourself a chance to break through an old routine or old way of doing or thinking about yourself. And Taurus is all about increasing your value. This deserves an increase. This deserves you changing yourself, changing your life, changing your perspective about what you, how you think about yourself in your life every single day. This is also about being grateful for what you do have and let that be the breakthrough that you need to have a new idea on how you can go about changing your life in the circumstances that you have so that you have more of an emotional balance than just everything always being about the physical. All right, Taurus, that's my reading for you guys this Leo season. Have a good one. Peace.